Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to obtain the probability of a Poisson distribution by using Casio calculator. First, we key in the function with lambda fixed. For this case, it's 1.2. So we have lambda 1.2 to the power of x. X is unknown, so we press alphabet. Close bracket to get x, and we times e to the power of shift ln. We put bracket since we have negative here, negative lambda 1.2. Close bracket, and we divide x factorial. So again, alphabet, close bracket, shift inverse to get factorial. Then we press calculate. The calculator will ask for x value. Then we check the question. The question asks for 3. So we key in 3 and press equal. Then we will obtain the correct probability. Next, how about last day, the question asks for an interval. So we can determine the value one by one. First, we obtain the probability for x is equal to 1. So we calculate again when x is equal to 1, we press equal. So we already obtain the probability, and we don't immediately press it to when x is equal to 2, because at the end we have to sum up all the probabilities here. So I will first store the value. Shift recall to get store. Where should we store? Press the button that contain any letter, for example button that with A. So we press left to check. Since it's already stored, so we can delete A. Now we proceed when x is equal to 2. So same procedure, press calculate, and we 1, 2 now. So press equal, so have the value again. Store, shift recall. Now for B, check, store, delete, calculate, 3 equal. So this is the value when x is equal to 3. Again, we have to store. So shift recall, store in C. Again, check, yes, store, delete. Now we move on to x is equal to 4. So we calculate when x is equal to 4. Again, shift recall to store. Check, yes, already store. So we already have A, B, C, D for 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively. So we press AC. Now we press alphabet button with A plus alphabet button with B plus alphabet button with C plus alphabet button with D, and we press equal. Then we will obtain the total probabilities that we are looking for. Okay, as we can see, this method is faster as compared to the normal way that we apply, where we have to press one by one. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.